To create the station permissions example described in the manual, and to help explain and test its operation, it would be helpful if we could reveal the whole of the automatic route that iTrain creates. In this episode, we show how to set that up. By default, when we start automatic routing without a route, only the first two blocks are reserved and displayed on the switchboard. Two reserved blocks are considered the optimum number when running trains. It reserves just enough blocks ahead for the train to utilize, but leaves the other blocks for other trains to use. A slight variation may be needed depending on the layout design and operation, but most commonly two blocks is optimum. But when we are creating and testing the conditions that will influence automatic routing without a route, it would be helpful if we could see more of the route that iTrain has chosen. And ideally, it would be nice to reveal a complete lap of this layout, for example. In this episode, we will show you how. But it must be emphasized that the technique we're going to show only works for automatic routing without a route. It will only reveal the route chosen for that particular iteration of the route, and it should be used with caution because it will impact a running layout. By all means, try the technique, but restrict it to offline use, as we are doing here, and revert back to normal settings before using a live running layout. The maximum number of blocks to complete a lap of this layout, if we're starting from this point, is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 blocks. So in the train types editor, under the options tab, we're going to increase the block reservation count to 10 and press apply. Now when we stop and restart the route, we see that we are only seeing 3 blocks reserved, because by default, as we saw in the last episode, iTrain does not reserve blocks beyond the location of the next wait, so that the track beyond that point remains available for other trains to use whilst that train is travelling to the station and completing its wait. But there's an option within the station which allows us to continue the reservation beyond the station to the next station. And that is in train types, selecting the relevant train type, and then in this reservation parameter, changing it from its default of none to continue. Now, when we stop and start, the reservation is extended beyond this wait to the station where the next wait occurs. And then we simply do the same for this station, setting that to continue. And now the route will extend beyond this station to the next station. In this particular example, iTrain could choose either route. So if we repeat and repeat again, you see at this point there is a decision for iTrain to make, and it can choose either of these routes. So to extend or continue the route from these points, we change reservation to continue in both these stations. And now it reveals a complete lap of this layout. And each iteration of the route could reveal a different path. So now we can clearly see the different routing possibilities for this particular setup. So that is all for this tutorial. As stated earlier, this technique only works for automatic routing without a route. It will only show the route chosen for that particular iteration of the route, but other possible paths are available. And it should be used with caution and preferably restricted to only using in offline mode, because these settings will impact the operation of a live running layout. But it's a very useful technique to use for debugging and testing automatic routing without a route. And for these tutorials, it will make it much easier for us to see the difference in train behavior when we start changing the station permissions in the next tutorial. So until then, bye for now.